Joining us now is Philippine Senator Nancy Binay for her assessment on the government's COVID-19 response. She's also one of the senators who have been calling for Health Secretary Duque's resignation amid the pandemic. Good morning, Senator Binay, and thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Christian, and good morning to all your televiewers.
Okay, now this call for Duque's resignation, you've made this along with several of your colleagues much earlier. But what do you make of the president's refusal to sack the health secretary, given the perceived inadequacies or the actual inadequacies that we've seen coming from the health department?
Siguro, I share the same sentiment of Senator Ping Lacson. It can be very frustrating. Kasi nakita naman natin na mukhang hindi talaga kaya ni Secretary Duque itong problema natin sa COVID. For me, Christian, when we had that first hearing sa Senate with regards to COVID-19 was already red flag dun sa capability of Secretary Duque. Kung matatandaan natin during that hearing, noong first case pa lang natin of COVID, dun lumabas na wala palang ginagawang contact tracing. I mean, that was the first sign. And then another one, nagkaroon kami ng isa pang hearing na dun lumabas na kaya pala mababa yung cases natin sa Pilipinas during that time. I think this was around late Feb or early March. Eh kasi wala pala tayong testing kits in terms of testing capabilities. Kulang na kulang pala tayo during that time. So, nakaka-frustrate. But you know, at the end of the day, it's the call of the president whether to let go of Secretary Duque. But siguro, maybe it's high time for the secretary to do some soul searching kung if he really can do the job. Baka kailangan sa kanya namang galing.
Well, ang argument kasi ng presidente, hindi naman si Secretary Duque daw yung nagdala ng COVID-19 sa Pilipinas. And I think another question is this. How would the resignation of Secretary Duque basically help improve things, if not perhaps solve many of the problems?
Well, una-una, he's the napaka-crucial ng posisyon ng arrest department of ng head ng Department of Health, and that is the position of Secretary Duque. Kumbaga, siya yung alter ego of the president pagdating dito sa kung paano natin pagdadaanan, paano tayo mananalo pagdating dito sa laban natin sa COVID. And so far, he's not been doing the right job in solving this problem.
Oo, pero sa tingin nyo, hindi ba, no? Parang somehow, much of the blame should also be on the president, because number one, aside from the fact that he was the one who put him there, number two, if you look at the dynamics within the IATF, within the group that's actually running the show, it seems that there are certain limitations on the part of the health secretary, especially given the very strong personality or leadership style of the president, that somehow it appears na mukhang hindi siya masabihan. Miski minsan mali yung sinasabi niya. For example, the kerosene as disinfectant statement, di ba?
Well, baka isa pa yan dun sa weakness ni Secretary Duque. Kung baka kulang yung convincing power niya with the president in giving suggestions on how we can solve this COVID-19 problem. Mm. Baka that is also part of the problem na parang hindi rin masyado nakikinig sa kanya si presidente.
Which is, of course, a problem because when we're dealing with the health crisis, a pandemic, it should be a health expert on top, di ba?
Well, isa yun din sa requirements na, I mean, kailangan natin ngayon.
Mm-hmm. Now, anong tingin niya dito sa ano? Dito sa response coming from the president to this distress call coming from medical frontliners? Of course, to be fair to the president, he basically acceded to the appeal of the medical societies. Basically, he placed Metro Manila and nearby provinces under MECQ, although the request was for an ECQ. But aside from that, he decided to basically castigate, to berate the medical frontliners, claiming that they were calling for a revolution, and number two, for airing their grievances in a webinar in public. And according to Malacanang, the president was last to know. What do you think of this response coming from the president at this time?
well, unang-una, I welcome the move, kahit hindi ECQ, but I think win-win compromise itong MECQ. So for that, I welcome this move by the president. But pagdating nga dun sa pag-castigated dun sa mga health workers natin, sana lang na wag natin tignan na kaaway sila. And I think dun din papasok si Secretary Duque. Because, di ba, kumbaga, he has the ear of the president eh, if he was able to explain it properly. Baka the president wouldn't get that impression na yung mga health workers natin are staging a revolution.
Pero hindi ba pag binasa naman yung letter, Senator Binay, maliwanag naman dun, walang mention of any revolution?
Well, you're assuming that the president read the letter. Diba? Baka may nagkwenta, baka may nagsabi lang sa kanya dun sa content ng letter.
Which could be worse. Kasi if you're going to react that vehemently, that passionately against our medical frontliners, tired and overworked as they are, at the very least, the leader should have read the appeal.
Yeah, but you know, we don't know eh. I'm not privy to how things are done inside the president's cabinet. But you know, at the end of the day, for me, parang our health workers didn't deserve that kind of lashing.
But
you know, I guess moving forward, you have to move on. Eh. We have 2 weeks. Parang we have a 2-week window wherein we can correct things. And hopefully, sana yung IATF would constantly be in touch with our health worker, with our health workers, with our doctors. Para tuloy-tuloy yung dialogue nila, tuloy-tuloy yung pag-uusap nila on how we can find the solution to this problem.
Number one, do you agree with the assessment of the medical frontliners that we are waging a losing battle against COVID-19? And actually, they're calling for a consolidated and definitive plan of action. Ibig sabihin, ang implication on, by implication, by making that call, mukhang walang consolidated and definitive plan of action at this time after more than 4 months of quarantine.
Ako, I agree with our medical practitioners. Kami sa Senado, we've been asking for a plan. I've been asking for a plan. Unang-una nga, Christian, for example, parang wala tayong communication plan on how we can teach our people what to do. For example, ikaw, Christian, pag nagkaroon ka ng symptoms of COVID, would you know how to get a swab test? And kung wala kang pambili, pambayad dun sa swab test, eh, would you know what number to call, where to go to get free swab test?
Oo. At saka basically, ano yung protocols? Diba? Pag nakaramdam ka ng symptoms, where do you go?
Yes, walang ganun. And then, kunwari, pag nag-positive ka, who do you inform? Ako, based from my experience, ha, meron akong kakilalang mga nag-positive. Sinabihan nila yung barangay nila. Ang sagot sa kanila ng barangay nila, I'm sorry, wala kaming lugar na pagdadalan sa inyo para pwede kayong mag-quarantine. And then there's this COVID positive patient na hindi in limbo. Tapos hindi niya alam kung paano niya paprotektahan yung pamilya niya nakasama niya sa bahay. So yung mga ganong detalye, tingin ko may pagkukulang. At doon natin, at doon yun dapat nating tutukan during this 2-week period.
Oh, but I think to be fair to the government, specifically the DILG, I think merong establishment of barangay epidemiology teams, for example. Actually, they would deal with the COVID cases. Alam ko may ganun eh. Yung binabanggit niyo, Senator, baka naman ano siya specific to one particular local government or a barangay which was not that responsive, for example.
Pero una-una, itong sinasabi kong cases, Metro Manila na to, ha? Di ba dapat, I think dito sa Metro Manila, 100% all barangays would know what to do. Like, for example, kasi ito nga dun sa LGU na kinakwento ko, puno na yung quarantine facility ng LGU. And then parang, yun na, wala nang hindi na nila alam kung ano yung next phase. Do they call a national hotline number para yung national government would take over and kumbaga magiging responsibilidad na nila itong COVID positive patient. Kasi mga ganong detalye, not everybody knows what to do.
Now, you mentioned this crucial two-week period which was requested by our medical frontliners. Basically, they wanted a breather and the government gave it to them. But of course, instead of an ECQ, the government declared a modified enhanced community quarantine. Nasa sense natin dito yung balancing act, di ba? So, hindi ganun ka-strict, pero strict pa rin kahit papano. Now, what else should the government do during this very crucial window?
Ako nga, well, una-una, yun nga, we need to have a very comprehensive communication plan. Well, number one, di ba, meron namang basic health protocols wherein we can avoid the virus. For example, yung washing of hands. But, yun nga, isang problema, Christian, washing of hands. Saan tayo mag-wash ng hands? Wala namang, makikita tayo mga washing stations. So maybe that's another project that the ITF can do is to set up more hand washing stations. Baka sa mga public markets, meron tayong mga ganyang facility. And then when it comes to face masks, baka kailangan the government could procure and give away free face masks. In fact, ako, Christian, ang target ko by December, I want to give away 100,000 face masks. Lalong-lalo na doon sa mga backliners. Ito yung mga jeepney drivers, mga nagtitinda ng balot, buko, yung mga ganong mga kababayan natin who belongs to the informal sector. Well, what yun din sa pwede natin gawin. Oh. And then, yun nga, yung making it known, yung steps, di ba? Yung kunwari, what to do? Baka we need to do an campaign na hindi lang online ha, because hindi naman lahat may online presence. For example, baka pwede katulad ng ginagawa namin pag nagkakampanya kami sa eleksyon, baka kailangan meron tayong yung umiikot na jeep na may trumpeta na sinasabi na parang, oh, ito yung hotline number, pag may nararamdaman kayo, ito yung tatawagan nyo. I think we need to do something like that
Of course yung importante rito, for example yung reinforcing the healthcare system, because we know that we're having problems when it comes to available beds. Some of the hospitals, or many of the hospitals, have already declared a full capacity. What else should the government focus on during this brief 2 week period, and do you think this is enough in 2 weeks na yan?
Well, hopefully, sana we're praying that it would be enough. Kasi nga, katulad dun sa sinabi ni Congresswoman Kimbo, that we are losing 12 billion a day dito sa two-week na MECQ. So, we need to balance yung need to earn for a living at yung to prevent na magkaroon tayo ng virus, di ba? So I think during this two-week period, yun na nga una-una, let us strengthen our contact tracing. Yun din may anlaki ng pagkukulang pagdating dun sa contact tracing. Siguro balikan ko na lang yung itong kinakwento ko na nag-COVID positive, di ba? Dito siya na-test sa Makati, so technically Makati patient, COVID patient siya, pero talaga nakatira siya sa Cavite. So, paano yung ganong coordination? So, babalik na naman tayo. Maybe we need to set up a hotline number or a call center para may ganong sistema. Una-una, kailangan natin talaga ng paggamit ng technology na mas madali yung magiging trabaho ng contact tracing.
Okay, finally, Senator Binay, I remember when senators were actually asking questions to the health worker, to the frontliners, for example, representatives from the DOH, in one of your hearings during the lockdown. You were among those who were asking very pointed questions with the DOH. Now, at this time, more than 4 months of lockdown, one of the longest in the world, do you still get the sense that the government is in control, and as Malacanang claimed, is that we are on the right track in dealing with this pandemic? And number two, how do you view this petition? I think there's a new petition change.org, petitioning the majority of the cabinet to declare the president unfit to discharge his duties because of the way the president has been dealing with this crisis. What do you think of this?
Well, una-una may appeals. Parang this is not the right time na mag-away-away tayo. We should focus all our resources and energy in fighting the virus. Kasi for me, yun talaga yung number one nating dapat na naawayan itong COVID-19. We all need to do our part. This is not just, it's not just government. It's all of us. Kumbaga, we need to learn how to live with this virus dahil uno-una, sa tingin ko, matagal pa yung vaccine. And for me, that is not just the solution to this problem. We need to do our part. Eh. And I think doon mahalaga yung role ng government kasi siya yung magsasabi kung ano yung dapat nating gawin. Kung ano yung kailangan nating gawin.
Okay.
And at the moment, mukhang doon ko nakikita na may malaking pagkukulang ang ating pamahalaan.
Okay. Senator Nancy Binay, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Christian.